Today we're going to be discussing several different things that are all somewhat related, but that don't really constitute a complete YouTube video on their own. Because, you know, that's what the YouTube algorithm likes. An impossible to title potpourri video about filter construction and step-up rings with a focus on knurling. But hey, let's get undone.
Gerald Undone. He's crazy.
What's happening, everybody? I'm Gerald Undone, and I suppose you're all wondering why I've gathered you here. Well, let me tell you how this all started. So you know that variable ND filter video that I made a while back? Well, since then, I've been quietly doing a separate roundup video on step-up rings, because in that previous video, I mentioned that I tend to just get the largest filter size and then step all of my lenses up to it. But let's face it, a step-up ring roundup video is not as sexy as a filter video, so I'm also going to throw in a little design done right segment on one of the most requested filters that I've ever been asked about, which is Polar Pro's ND16 and Polarizer combo filter. And I'm also going to give away my pick for my favorite step-up ring to someone in the comments who needs it, but more on that later. So let's start off with a filter. Now in my variable ND roundup video, I said that if you know the reduction that you're going to need, then you'll generally get better quality and usually pay a lot less if you just get a fixed ND filter. To which many of you asked, well, what about polarization? And usually that means you'd have to stack filters. But if you get a combo ND and polarizer filter like this one from Polar Pro, then you don't need to. This is a four-stop fixed ND with a circular polarizer built in. A quick way to convert the ND scale that Polar Pro uses into stops is by using your exponents of 2. So 2 to the power of what equals 16? Well, 4. 2 times 2 times 2 times 2 equals 16. 4 twos, 4 stops. So the main reason for getting a filter like this instead of just a fixed ND would be to control the distribution of polarization and the funky light reflections in the frame. You can rotate it to better hit the water in the bottom of your shot, or better hit the sky in the top, or even if you want to control the intensity of the green in your foliage and grass. You know, all the same things that you would use a polarizer for. Now you can still stack filters on this one if you want, because there's a full set of threads on the front of this filter, but I find that for the type of versatile run and gun shooting that I would use a filter like this for, that 4 stops is actually pretty good, and with the polarizer built in, that's pretty much all that you would need, because I find that on my variable NDs, I'm usually between 3 to 5 stops anyway. And of course the other advantage of a filter like this, because it's a fixed ND, is that you don't have to worry about any cross-type patterns, and you won't get heavy vignetting because you probably won't be stacking filters. But another way to ensure minimal vignetting, like I recommended in my previous video, is to get the largest filter and then use step-up rings to adapt to it. But we'll get more into that in a second. But overall, the quality of this filter is exceptional. The quartz element has terrific clarity, the brass frame is incredibly durable, and it's scratch and oil resistant. There's also no noticeable color shift, except for the expected effect of polarization on blue skies, etc., but your white is still white, which is good. It also comes in at pretty much exactly the 4 stops advertised, which will make conversions easy if you're running different setups. And last but certainly not least, the outside edges of this filter are, as Polar Pro puts it, aggressively knurled. And I'm a big fan of knurling. For those that don't know, knurling is when lines, which can be crossed, angled, or straight, are rolled into a material, typically metal, and usually by a lathe. And when executed well, it creates this very satisfying tactile experience that is definitely deserving of a music-driven montage. One of the subjects in that sequence was the Sony 90mm macro, which is my favorite Sony lens, and the knurling on the focus clutch is one of the reasons why I love it so much. Polar Pro also puts this knurling on their step-up rings, and speaking of these step-up rings, I'm about to drop some superlatives here, so before I do, let me remind you that this video is not sponsored, it hasn't been reviewed or endorsed by Polar Pro, and none of the videos in my Design Done Right series are ever sponsored, and they're motivated purely by my own compulsion to talk about features that I really enjoy. So with that being said, Polar Pro step-up rings are some of the best designed lens accessories I've ever seen. You got the ideal lack of gloss on the finish, the perfect weight, heavy enough to know it's quality and rugged, but not so heavy it stops making sense, that aggressive knurling, impossibly smooth threads, and completely symmetrical gaps in the knurling to provide a surface for the logo and the filter size, which utilizes a smart and clean font choice. And speaking of filter size, rings will always go from lens to filter. So on this one here, it says 62mm to 82mm. That's a 62mm lens, front filter diameter, to an 82mm filter, and it always goes in that order. If the second number is larger, then it's a step-up ring. If the second number is smaller, then it's a step-down ring. But the second number will always represent the filter. Now, as I mentioned earlier, I actually did a whole giant roundup of step-up rings featuring about a dozen Amazon specials as well as some premium brands. And here are my findings. The Polar Pros are definitely my favorite, but they're also the most expensive. But to their credit, each one does come with excellent packaging as well as a hard protective case. It might seem like overkill for a step-up ring, but I do appreciate the little touches if a product is going to have a price premium. The only thing that bugs me about the Polar Pros is the sizing. They don't have as wide of a size range as some other brands. So for instance, when I needed to go from 58mm to 82mm, I had to get a 58 to 67 and then a 67 to 82 and stack them in order to cover that spread. Which brings me to my second favorite from Breakthrough. Breakthrough Photography also has premium step-up rings, and they cover a wider range of sizes. So for example, my Sony 35mm f1.8 lens has a 55mm filter diameter, and so this step-up ring here goes from 55mm to 82mm all in one step. But the reason why they don't get my number one spot is because they're not that much cheaper than Polar Pro, but don't look quite as nice, don't have any of the case or accoutrement, and they aren't as easy to get on and off. They go on the lens quite easily, but I do find that they tend to bind the filters a little bit harder, so sometimes it can be harder to separate your filter from the step-up ring, which can take a little bit more time, where the Polar Pros are smooth in both directions. And even though they do feature my beloved knurling, I find them to be a little bit heavy. Usually weight is a positive indicator of quality or the materials used, but they don't quite strike the balance that Polar Pro does between weight and quality, and I find these to fall a little bit on the needlessly heavy side. But for the most part, these complaints are quite nitpicky, and Breakthrough's rings are excellent and very deserving of the number two spot. For my third and final pick, I'm going to move on to something quite a bit cheaper, but not so cheap that you'll be annoyed you bought them. Some of the really cheap rings that I tested take like 5 times longer to actually thread them on and off, and some of the worst ones actually require you to remove them with a pair of pliers before immediately throwing them in the trash. But these ones from Photodeox are pretty good. They're cheap and definitely feel light and probably not as heavy duty as the other ones we mentioned, but they're reasonably smooth to get on and off, they seem to have pretty good quality control, and they come in a reasonably wide range of sizes. But no knurling. Now, just like the Polar Pros, you're probably going to need to stack them to get the wider coverage. So for this one here, I've got it going from 49mm to 67, and then 67 to 82. But at a quarter of the price of the premium ones, they get the job done. Now, I'm sure you guys are going to fill the comments with a bunch of brands that I didn't mention or ones that you personally prefer, but my omission of your step-up ring does not mean that it sucks, it just means that I probably didn't get to it because there is an insane amount of these out there to test. But of the 14 that I did try, these are my 3 favorite at 3 different price points. And I would probably avoid the $2 to $3 ones on Amazon because I think that they're probably more trouble than they're worth. And the Photodeox is sort of the price range that's the lowest that I would personally go. But feel free to let me know in the comments if you've had some success with other step-up rings that I didn't mention here, if you think they're definitely worth a buy. But I'll put links to all of these in the description below, of course. The Polar Pro ones you can get pretty much everywhere, including their own store, which has great service. But the Breakthrough Photography ones seem to be an Adorama exclusive because I couldn't really find them on B&H. But I did try ordering from their own Breakthrough Photography store, which was great, and the service was excellent. The Photodeox ones, though, you can get on either, or you can go with Amazon. Anyway, that's pretty much it. I've had this mountain of filter paraphernalia sitting on my table for the last couple months that I wanted to make a video on, so thanks for letting me do that, and I hope that this was useful despite it being less focused than my other videos. And from that mountain, I have one item that is still sealed in its original box that I just didn't need for my testing, and that is this 72 to 77mm step-up ring from Polar Pro, and so I figured since this is my favorite step-up ring, I might as well give one away. So just let me know in the comments if you could put a step-up ring like this to good use, and then in 48 hours, I'll pick a winner and ship it to you. I'm going to include this video in my Design Done Right series because I think Polar Pro is really doing awesome work. I'm a big fan of the variable NDs. This ND polarizer combo filter is fantastic, and their step-up rings are some of the best I've ever seen. And I even got to take a little tour of their facility and meet their staff when I was doing that Golden Hour podcast at the end of August. I'll put a link to that in the description, by the way, in case you guys haven't seen it yet. It answers a bunch of questions that you guys often ask about some of my branding decisions and a bit of my origin story. But my point was, their staff is very friendly, and their service is outstanding. Polar Pro is doing pretty much everything right, in my opinion, and that definitely includes design. But feel free to let me know in the comments if you've had some success. But that's going to be it for me. I hope you found this video entertaining or at least helpful, and if you did, make sure you leave it the old thumbs up and consider subscribing if you haven't already. But if you did not find this video helpful or entertaining, well, then you probably weren't knurled enough as a baby. All right, I'm done.